I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue thinking about you. Decorations are red on every Christmas tree. Won't be the same, dear, if you're not here with me. I'll have a blue Christmas.
Oh yeah, they start falling now. Come on.
And when those blue memories start calling, you'll be doing all right with the Christmas of white. But I'll have a blue, 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 blue Christmas. Blue.
Y'all do what I do. That's Chuck. That's Elvis Presley.
How about you? I'll have blue memories without you. You'll be doing all right when the Christmas of white. But I have a blue, 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 blue Christmas.
All right now. There you go. Oh, oh, more Christmas stuff. I like that Christmas, Christmas, Christmas. Here comes Santa Claus.
Sleigh bells ring. All right. In the land, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight. We're happy tonight.
Walking in the winter wonderland.
Going away.
Come on, then, Ray, sing.
It's a bluebird.
Y'all gonna have a good Christmas now. Come on.
It's a new bird. He sings a love song as we go along.
Walking in the winter wonderland.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. What is my past graduate sister Shirley Williams in person and her Snooky? Hey, you should be getting a lot of attention from your son now. Foot massage, knee replacements, all kind of good stuff.
We'll frolic and play.
I might have to come up there for Christmas and sit around the Christmas tree. Sing some Christmas songs. Joe Snooky.
We'll sing us up and go along. Walking in the winter wonderland.
All right, what we gonna play next here? Let's see.
You're a mean one,
Mr. Grinch. I don't know all these.
You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel.
I guess that's one of the kids, How the Grinch Stole Christmas. Any kids out there? Huh? Bad kids? Yeah. Go get your bad kids. Tell them, put your bad kids out here. I told them a story of Jesus. Tell them why, the reason for the season. Come out here. Where you at, you little bad kids? Huh? You there yet? All right. Uncle Yes can tell you a little story.
Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole.
Got a crush on my too. It's a good thing.
You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch.
Handsome.
You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick.
Okay, little kitties.
Mr. Grinch.
Especially you little bad ones.
Given the choice between the two of you,
that's what you over there sitting right there. Okay.
You're
you ready?
Mr. Grinch. You're
now,
a nasty
when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, where is he that was born king of the Jews? Because we have seen his star in the east, and we come to worship him.
Mr. Grinch,
he came into the world,
that he might reveal his father to mankind. Your
he put on divinity to put on humility. He became the Son of Man to become the Son of God. He grew to manhood unnoticed, without wealth or prestige. He even untraveled, didn't go nowhere. In his youth, he startled the kings. In boyhood, he puzzled the wise. And in manhood, he ruled the course of nature. Listen, he never practiced medicine. Yet he healed a multitude free of infirmities. He healed the sick, raised the dead, gave sight to the blind, and then ruled out evil spirits with his almighty word. He delivered and rehabilitated the alcoholic, the addict, the outcast. He bound up the brokenhearted. And then, he imparted new life, confidence, and ambition to the rejected.
You
know what else? He never marched in an army.
You want the real deal?
He never drafted a soldier.
State Farm is there.
He never employed a weapon. And yet, no leader has ever had to volunteers who under his command subdue the nation. Oh, listen, he's a star of heaven. He's a rock of salvation. He's a lamb of God. He's a harmonizer of all discord. He's a burden bearer and a giver of rest. Just watch this. Herod couldn't kill him. Satan couldn't seduce him. Death couldn't destroy him, and the grave couldn't hold him.
But she forgot her
he was rich, but for our sake, he came poor that he might be rich.
The door into the snow.
He laid aside his purple gown for a peasant's gown. He stepped in another's manger, rode another's beast. He had no grain fields or fish hatcheries. He spread a table for 5,000, have bread and fish to spare. And then he gave up his life on Calvary's cross. A few more, but the sun was darkened. Men trembled, not for their sins, but the earth shook under their feet. Nature honored him. Sinners alone rejected him. Corruption could not take his body. His death and resurrection was contrary to the laws of nature. And he grew to manhood, an image of our invincible God. Now you have to ask yourself a question. Was it Mary the son of Mary and Joseph that walked the world alive for some 2,000 years ago? Or was it human blood that was spilled on Calvary's cross for the redemption of sin? Better call him by his name, Lord, Lord, my God. That matchless Christ, my Savior. Merry Christmas.
Grandma got run over by a reindeer.